Hello everybody, my name is Jennifer and I'm going to be doing my first ever YouTube review on my brand new Fluance Reference Series High Fidelity Turntable System, ordered directly from Fluance.com. Last year in May, when this COVID insanity started, I was in search of a new turntable, and having done reviewed lots of other YouTube reviews, I selected the Fluance RT85 because I needed something with a built-in preamp to go with a wireless powered speaker. Excuse me. Anyway, so it's been about 9-10 months and I'm kind of a fanatic on performance and the things that I buy. So I wanted to see what this unit was like since I'd heard so many good things. And let's start. It is very heavy. It came packaged very, very well. The box is in very, very good condition. Coming all the way from New York, Canada, and I'm way down in South Texas. No dents, no dings. And tell you what, if you like my video, please like and leave a positive comment. And if you don't want to leave a positive comment, I can handle it either way. So let's open this thing and see what I've got. I've been waiting anxiously because, as you know, last week we had the entire state was frozen, so nothing was being shipped. But all right, let's get it open. Now, the question, what do I open this box with? Because I've watched lots of other men do these reviews, and the reason I decided to do one was because, you know, men get real technical with a lot of these like decibel things and these little acronyms that, you know, most of us women are not going to understand, especially, you know, if we want to buy one for our significant other or for ourselves. And I was hoping to make one that was kind of nuts and bolts of what we as women or a beginner might be wanting to hear about a particular product. So again, let's open this thing. And again, I don't know what to open it with because I've seen a lot of these men come out with, well, let's see. There's the big survival knife. Got all its gadgets, I think, in the handle here. You know, so we could use the big survival knife, I guess, for this box and a little strip of tape, but you know, most women aren't gonna have the survival knife, so let's put that aside. We could also use this double-edged pointed dagger, good for defensive purposes. Don't ask me why I have this. I'm sure it would do the job too. And then there's this little pocket knife with a quick opening spring activated blade, serrated bottom. Again, really, really sharp. It would do the job, but again, we're just talking about a little piece of tape and, you know, something we women are gonna have lying around the house quite readily. But speaking of men and knives, and you know, if a woman really wanted to use a big knife for something, how could you go wrong with one of these? Anyway, you get my point. So, what I'm gonna be using is a basic pair of scissors that break open in the middle, have a little serrated blade, and I'm gonna go zip, and zip, and zip, and do like this, and looky there. Oh my gosh, that box was open. And I really don't know why I didn't use this. Probably because I didn't need to, and you know, big muscles and stuff aren't the most key factor. So anyway, here we go. Let's open it up and see what we've got. So bear with me. As I said, this is my first ever YouTube review. And I bought the Fluance a year ago because of so many great reviews that I had seen online and comparing stats, and I'm kind of a geek, always have been. The last time I had a turntable was in the early 80s, and that was a brand new Technics SL1200 Mark II that my parents bought in 1979 for my big, tall, typical, all silver fronted stereo rack with all the components, and I was really spoiled. And then while I was off to college in the mid 80s, having started with cassettes and CDs had come into play, I came home one weekend, entered my room, and most of my equipment was gone, including my turntable. And I said, "Mom, what'd you do with my turntable?" She said, "Oh, I sold it in a garage sale." I said, "You did what?" I said, "For how much?" She goes, "Well, $35. I didn't think you'd use it anymore." Yeah. Isn't that one biting me on the butt now? So I'd heard lots of great things. Anyway, I got the RT81, as I said, and I've loved it. I really have. I've got absolutely zero complaints, except one teeny tiny little factor. And this comes down to when I switch from listening to an album to flicking over to a CD or FM radio, and there's a dramatic volume difference when I haven't turned my dial. Now, I realized that CDs are recorded for a much higher output, and that is kind of understandable. But I still wasn't quite sure what was going on, and I did look at one of the stats on the RT81, which says the line out / phono out, whether you're using the internal preamp or not, is 2.5 millivolts. I don't know what a millivolt is, but if you use the line out, you have to go into one of your like auxiliary ports on your receiver if it doesn't have a phono, and you flip the little switch into the to use the phono if you're going to go into a receiver that has a phono input for its built-in preamp. Anyway, I did notice that on a lot of the higher end tables, from Fluance to I guess Rega, Project, even the Techniques, their phono output is, including this RT85, is 5.5 millivolts. So I'm thinking that higher number might give me a little more volume presented without changing my dial. But anyway, this Fluance table is an exceptional value for everything that I have read up on. For example, I mean, from the RT82, 3, 4, and 5, they're all the same base with three conical shaped adjustable feet for leveling. And the big difference being with the RT85, it comes with the Ortofon 2M Blue moving magnet cartridge. Well, on Amazon, that cartridge alone retails for about $236. The acrylic platter that weighs in at a whopping 3 pounds for this RT85 is $120 directly from Fluance. So you're getting the whole package with the cartridge and the platter for $500. And again, I love my 81. I don't know if I'm gonna keep it or try and sell it on the secondary market, but I really thought that I would like this unit, and I wanted to see what it was like. I bought it with my own money. It was not provided to me free. So this is just me doing a review. So as I said, let's start taking this thing out of the box. So let's see. When I first take it off, that's going to be the dust cover, and I'm just going to set it off to the side. Next thing, I've got my manual. Oh wow, and it comes with a pair of, look, little white gloves. How nice. Yes, I could put those on, but I'm pretty careful with my hands and what I touch, and I wipe things off and I'm very clean anyway. So I'm gonna set that aside for the moment too. And then, let's see what this is. This is, my audio video cable, left and right, and my grounding wire. Oh, and a little bubble level to make sure that you've got the table completely level, which is very important. And also the power adapter and a little apt adapter for the 7-inch 45 RPM records that I had back in my early youth with my first little carrying case kind of turntable. So I'm gonna set that aside as well. And wow, let's see what we're gonna do on this now. This is, okay, kind of heavy, but I just lifted it out of there like that. So bear with me, I'm gonna balance this like so. Oh, I used to be a server at a restaurant too, so. Coffee, tea, anyone? Carefully set it down on my table. Let's see, what else is in the box? Okay, down at the very bottom of the box, I'm gonna bet, because this is pretty heavy, this is probably the acrylic platter. So I'll get to that in just a minute. I'm gonna easily take off these styrofoam edges. And on the very end of those, okay, there we've got, looks like, here's our cartridge. There is the head shell with the Ortofon 2M blue. And this looks to be part of the hinge for the dust cover. I'm not gonna worry about putting that on right now. So, set that aside. And on this side is another hinge for the dust cover. So again, I'll set that aside. Not gonna worry about that one right now. I did order my first RT81 in the mahogany wood grain, I think that's what it is. But I ordered this one in the piano black, just to be different. I'm not sure why. They're both gorgeous. They're made out of hard-pressed MDF, so they're very, very heavy. I think this one comes in at around 18 pounds, so it's very solid. And again, ladies, for what I've read and heard, it's all about, you know, the guys are going resonance and extra vibrations, yada, yada, yada. What do we want out of a turntable? Well, simplicity. I want to be able to turn it on, have it run at the right speed. I love the manual aspect of putting the record on and setting the stylus down and listening to an album that sounds good. I hear words about, you know, separation and la-da-da. Does any of us really know what that means? I mean, girls and novices, we want it to be simple, we wanna hook it up, and we want it to sound good. So, what I've got now is this beautiful table, see? Nice, shiny piano black. Tone arm is secured with a little wire. And having done this before, it's pretty simple. I'm gonna carefully take out my cartridge. And this is a bayonet style mount. So with the tone arm still secured, you simply just slide it in. There's a little peg right on top. So it goes in nice and easy. Couple of three little turns, and there we go. And it's nice and secure. So I'm gonna undo the little twist tie that's holding everything secure. They did a great job for all of this as far as protecting it. And there's a little lock switch right there that I'm gonna undo. And there's some protective tape just around that. So I'll take that off. And while I'm doing this, I'm gonna go ahead and put the little lock back on. Now, let's see, what else? Was there anything that I missed? There's an adapter, little gloves. Ah, the one other thing, I knew I was missing something when I saw the tone arm. The tone arm weight. Oh, that's a heavy sucker. So, what I really know about this, to start with, you take the little tone arm, and it's got a little dial on it. It's got some little digits there from 0 all the way around to 2.5 there, which would be back to 3 if you turn it. You come in on the back of the tone arm and you push it in until it clicks and kind of locks in. So there you have it. That's pretty much done at that point. Now, I'm not going to go through the process of leveling right now because this is not where it's going to sit. I'm going to set it probably back up here. And I don't have a whole lot of room in my apartment. Everything's kind of against one wall and in a corner. My RT81 is over in that corner on a nice little rack that I bought. And I have a completely separate receiver, modern Sony SDRD-H190. Two channel stereo with a phono input, and it sounds fantastic. But being kind of a vintage nut, I hooked up, or I found on eBay, a 1980 Kenwood KR7050 in literally mint condition, like I had back in high school, and fell in love when I saw it. But kind of leery, I mean, oh my God, I'm buying something that's over 40 years old. What's it going to be like? Is it going to get here? Is it going to sound good? Are all the little things going to work? I got this, I don't remember who the guy was, and it was exactly like described. It is mint. It's beautiful. Sounds fantastic. Unlike the Sony, which I use primarily for my TV when I'm, just because I use it to listen to my TV. And it has a remote. This one doesn't. This is back to 1980 style. Everything's manual, tactile switches and all that good stuff. I love it. But this is not a review on my stereo system. It's a review on the Fluance RT85. So, let me break out this platter. Again, gosh, what knife do I use? How about, let's just go with the little scissor edge again. And I reach up here and just a little zip. And it's amazing how easy just that little bitty thing works. And you don't have to get out the manly, big, giant knife. Because, girls, we only want a big knife for one thing. And you know what I'm talking about. Wow. Okay, so this turned acrylic platter is heavy. It is solid. No cutouts on the bottom. Wow, this is gorgeous. This is gorgeous. So, I'm very careful. I'm holding, only putting my fingers on the spindle and the very bottom, and there's a bigger nut opening on the bottom, so I know which way that is. And let's see, there's a little place I know you've seen. There's a little dot right here that you line up with an arrow as far as where you want to. This is your motor and your turning system, and it's, there's a little, that's the little eye. That I'm saying, the little dot, yes, that's the eye that reads the speed of the platter, like lots and lots and lots of times per second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the platter down, and wow, you just, and that is gorgeous. So now what we do is we kind of reach up under here with our, I get my fingernail, get the belt, and oh my God, it's so easy. It just slips right around. And there you have it. So this is the base setup. So you have everything set up, ready to go. The next thing I'm gonna have to do though is balance the tone arm. Now, because this is an acrylic platter, you do not have to have another mat, whether it be rubber or cork or felt or anything, is you don't have to have anything. So, which that's really, really nice. So give me just a second and I'm gonna start getting things ready. I'm gonna go through the balancing process, and I said, girls, guys, of novices, this is where it's really, really important that you get everything set right, because otherwise your stylus, the little needle, it doesn't sit in the groove and it doesn't track right, and it won't give you the best sound. And again, what are we going for? We want something that sounds good, right? So here we go, and I'm gonna take this
And it says, I've already read the manual before because I've done this before. And you want to make sure your tracking dial is at zero, or I mean your anti-skate. It's a little bitty dial right over here on the side. You want to make sure that's at zero. And then you want to start turning. It's kind of like a little screw. You're turning clockwise to bring in. Whoops. Let's see. First thing I got to do. Okay, yeah. Take off the stylus cover because that adds just a little bit extra weight. And you want to turn this in until, or adjust it out until you can let go of it. And it floats. Let me get down here and look. Just literally almost perfectly horizontal. Let's see where that one. No, back it off just a little bit again. My hair keeps falling in my eyes, if you hadn't noticed. And that literally looks to be almost perfect. So it's not touching the platter. Well, that is right there, so. Okay, we're just over the platter, and it looks to be like my tone arm is completely level with the platter, so that's where we want that. Now, you take your tone arm, you slide it back, lock in right there. Then you have to come up and I have to get kind of close because the light's over in my eyes and I can't see. You turn the little dial, not the big part of the weight. And dadgummit, I really cannot see. Well, let's turn this around this way so I can see the little numbers. There we go. 0.5, zero. There's a white line there, so you set the zero on the little white line. And as I said, my tone arm is completely balanced. So I'm gonna unhook it again. I'm gonna see if I can show it to you this way. And this is letting it just hover. It's not touching the platter. It's level, all right? So again, we're gonna go back. I'm gonna lock this back in. I've got this counterweight zeroed, and the recommendation for the Fluance 2M Blue is 2 grams. So you go to this little bitty dial, not the counterweight that's part of the back, and you carefully turn the little dial. It's recommended for 2 grams. So you turn it until the 1.8 grams is the optimal level recommended for the Fluance. So I'm gonna set it right on the mark for 1.8. All right, so we've got that part done. And it should be balanced, but give me just a second and I'm gonna go get my digital scale and see how close I got doing that quick manual balancing. Give me just a second, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I got my little scale. It's a Neotech, it's a little digital stylus gauge that I got off of Amazon. It wasn't very expensive. I can't remember if it was $10, $15. No big deal. So we're gonna take this and we're gonna see exactly, we set it over here on the platter, and I'm gonna see how close I got a while ago just with a quick rough in. Let's see, make sure that's zeroed since it just took it out of the box. And it shows all zeros, okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna unlock the tone arm, very carefully come over, and we're gonna set the stylus. There's a little bitty hole right in the middle. Very carefully set the stylus in that hole, and let's see what it comes. I told you the optimal level recommended by Ortofon for this cartridge is 1.8 grams. And wow. 1.73 doing just my visual dialing on this particular cartridge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reach again back to the weight. I'm gonna hold my little arm here, and I'm going to turn just ever so slightly. One point seven seven. Okay, so again, I'm getting a little closer for perfection. So just a teeny tiny, I mean, just little bitty movement. One point 80. I did it. That's how close I got just by doing the rough balance and setup the way the instructions say. The next thing you want to do, all right, I'm going to take this off. I'm going to set it right back over here. I have plugged it into power. I'm going to lock the tone arm again. You have this one little dial over here on the side. Again, my tone arm is locked. I'm going to tilt this up. Right here, that's called your anti-skate, because centrifugal motion causes the tone arm to want to pull to a certain direction. And you want it to stay balanced and level in the groove. So, again, I'm kind of a fanatic. So what I did was I found this anti-skate calibration record. It's a blank piece of vinyl, smooth, that I found on eBay for $12. And it's nice and shiny. It's got a few little grooves in there because, again, the stylus is diamond. So it would make sense that I've got some little lines on there from testing my RT81. So what we do is I'm going to loosen up the lock again. I'm going to turn it over here to 33. This is the on switch, which platter starts turning just as soon as I move the arm. Now, anti-skate is recommended to sit at the same number as the tracking weight, which is about 1.8. So I'm going to dial this. There's a little arrow. And I'm going to dial over here. I've just got to 1. Each mark is 2. I'm going to get over to about 1.8. Okay. Now, I'm doing everything from behind, so I hope you can see me. I'll angle this so that hopefully you can see what the arm does. So I'm going to lift it. Platter starts spinning. I'm going to set it about midway in what would be the album. All right. It tracks. It's pulling a little bit inward. So I think that means I back off a little bit on the skate. Oh, it's pulling a little further. Let's see. Maybe I'm doing this wrong. Make sure I get it up right about 2. Okay. I am set here at 1.8 grams on the money for this particular setup. And my anti-skate, I've got literally right on the 2.0 mark. And as you can see, my tone arm isn't moving inward or outward, and there are no grooves on this skate disc. So it is perfectly skated. So I should get the optimal sound out of that in the grooves. See, that's what that looks like. Just a little clear disc. Well, there you have it. That is the basic unboxing and general setup for the RT85, 84, 83, 82, 81, and 80. That's it in a nutshell, girls and guys, novices. If I can do it, you can do it. So again, if you like the video, give me a big thumbs up, please, because this, again, is my first video review of any product ever. And I just felt compelled to do it. So here in just a little bit, I'm going to get it hooked up to my stereo. And I'm anxious to see what this sounds like, because it was delayed by weather for almost 5 days. So give me a sec. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I've got it hooked up to my Kenwood KR7050. I've connected the ground wires and the inputs. And I'm going to do a little sample of one of my favorite albums, Rush Moving Pictures, so that I give full credit. I do own the album. I don't know that I don't own the rights to the music. I don't know how all that works, but this is Rush Moving Pictures, And the song is YYZ. Just to give you a little sample, this is going to be my first sample. And here we go. I'm going to lower the tone arm level. Okay. So it's just at the very end of one of the other song. So let's see how it sounds. There you have it. What'd you think? This is my beautiful Piano Black Reference Series Fluance RT85 with the Ortofon 2M Blue Moving Magnet Cartridge. Again, cartridge alone valued at about $236 on Amazon if you were just thinking about upgrading your current turntable. But again, you've got a 3-pound acrylic platter, which they say that mass and the revolutions and all that good stuff improves the sound quality. Again, for girls and novice guys, we're trying to keep this simple. So, once again, without a whole lot of little bitty details, having listened to this and comparing the other, they're close because I've got no complaints about my RT81. None. If you are looking for an entry-level turntable, please do not get one of the little box things at Walmart. It will destroy your records and it sounds like crap. I'm a kind of fanatic because I want to go for the best that I can afford plus 20 to 25% because I know I'll regret it if I don't, and I'll end up spending more to do an essential upgrade anyway. But as I said, the RT81, no complaints. Fluance is a wonderful company. Their products are superb. And for the 81, I also have their reference series bookshelf speakers and their 10-inch powered sub, which sound phenomenal. I can't turn them all the way up because I live in an apartment, third floor, and the bass kind of booms and disturbs my neighbor downstairs. But same for these others. Vintage system, Kenwood, with Serwin Vega VE12 speakers, similar to what I had, again, back in high school, and I'm kind of a vintage nut. I love that kind of stuff. But this RT85 is, I've got to say, the best value for the money of anything on the market. I've had it, you saw me open the box. That's as long as I've had it, and I absolutely love it. $541, I think, delivered to my door. Packaging was perfect. Everything inside, perfect. Simple, simple setup. You saw me do everything it took to get this ready to go, except plug in the wires. So, if you're wanting a turntable to listen to vinyl, to get started in vinyl, and you're wondering, what do I get? Save your $200, $250. If you can afford the little bit extra for what you get. Like I said, my RT81 was $250 plus the same $41 to deliver. It had an 1895E cartridge as standard, which you can replace for $49. There's something in the value and the quality. It's a bottom level cartridge. This is a much, much higher end cartridge for more dynamic sound. The Cymbals are crisp and high. The drum beats are spot on. It's got good bass. It's got good mid-range. I love the overall sound from what I just heard, and I heard it with you. I have not listened to this turntable before then. So I highly, highly recommend it for the money. I don't even know that had I spent $1,000 on another system like one of the what is it? I think it's the Riga RP3, which is around $1,100 with a straight tone arm. And to me, that's not convenient, because if you ever want to change cartridge, I mean, it's these little screws are a little bitty, and then you've got to line everything. I mean, this bayonet mount on the S-shaped tone arm, you screw it in and tighten it, and it's good to go. Girls, guys, novices, this can't be beat. I've got nothing but fabulous things to say about this. And again, this was my first video. So if you like it, please give me thumbs up. And I hope you did enjoy it. And leave your comments wherever they go, because I don't know how you set that up. I've never done this before. But my name is Jennifer, and I love you. And I hope to be doing more of these in the future. This was fun. Enjoy. Bye-bye.